Hey, how's it going? Ed Ricker here, and this is the Beta 95X from Beta FPV, complete with the Cadex Vista HD video transmitter inside, and the entire thing weighs 164 grams, all up weight with a 4S battery. That's pretty impressive. Okay, so we have to talk. We're gonna talk about the Cadex Vista, which is kind of the hot new item for the DJI FPV system. We're also gonna talk about the Beta 95X, which is a larger version of the Beta 85X, just a larger frame that can accommodate 2.5 inch props. And the great thing about this is we can use the Cadex Vista system inside of this for a very lightweight, indoor flyer or outdoor flyer, as I demonstrated. And at only 164 grams, it's well below the threshold for registration in the United States. I'm pretty excited about the quad, but let's first talk about the Cadex Vista. The Cadex Vista is kind of like a smaller DJI FPV air unit. So it has the camera, it has the video transmitter, it also has the DJI HDL Link protocol receiver, so you can use the FPV radio if you'd like, and you don't have to use an external receiver. Although I am using Crossfire on this particular micro, I like my old radio better. I'm not such a fan of the FPV radio, but you can definitely use it with that and cut out even more weight. The Vista also comes with a DJI camera here, the FPV camera, and the cable's a little different from what you would see on a normal air unit. This one you can actually see the individual strands of the cable, which is interesting. And then it ends with these little connections here, and this harness kind of has to stuff inside. And what you do is you unscrew this part right here and then stuff this right in there and then tighten her back up. It has the same milliwattage transmission potential that the full-size air unit has. The only real difference is the Cadex Vista only has one antenna sticking out the back as opposed to the air unit's two antenna. Although that doesn't seem to really affect range in my experience. In fact, this has performed better than the air unit in a couple longer range tests that I did recently. You also have to solder directly to the Cadex Vista with the pads, like you have the voltage, you have the ground, your TX, your RX pads, and your connection for if you're using the FPV radio with the HDL protocol. But the biggest difference between the air unit and the Cadex Vista is the Vista you cannot record internally, which means you can only record from the goggles whatever transmission you're getting. So if you're flying really far away and your digital transmission starts to break up and get a little mushy, that's how your recording is gonna look. So that might be a deal breaker for some people. I've heard that it is for some people. For me, I think it's still really cool because it's DJI HD video, which is pretty good, up to even medium range. You fly behind some stuff, sure you're gonna get mush, but for the most part, flying in a close vicinity or proximity, you can get some great footage out of this. It is gonna be 720, so it's not 1080 or 4K or whatever. Again, that might be a deal breaker for some people, but to keep this as light as it is and for the capabilities and just to actually jam the DJI FPV system into a quad like this, there's a little bit of give and take. Maybe in a few years we'll see something down the road where we can have all that we want in a smaller form factor like this. But for now, we're stuck with what we have. So in that regard, I do appreciate that I have the DJI FPV system in a small little micro quad like this that I can fly indoors or outdoors, however my heart desires. Now, Cadex sent me the Vista, Beta FPV sent me the 95X, so together I put them in. I think if you were to buy the 95X as the HD version, which is almost about $300 US dollars, it's gonna come built in, but I had to build it myself. But that was a good learning process because I was able to figure out how I would fit this into other quads and see just how this kind of works and how it looks internally. The Vista gets hot, that's for sure. And because it's so much smaller, but it's putting out the same milliwattage output, it actually gets like painfully hot. If you thought the air unit got hot, this thing, whoo, could fry some eggs on it. It does have a USB-C port also has a bind button for your goggles, so you are going to have to go through your activation process like the air unit or like other DJI drones. You can't fly this to its full potential without activating it using the DJI Assistant 2 FPV series program, which you can download on the DJI website. Now, I only flew at 700 milliwatts over these last couple flights because I didn't want to bump up to 12, but comparing it to the air unit at 700 with two antennas, the Vista with one antenna was actually outperforming it in certain situations. There's this paved circuit at the edge of a park that I fly a lot around, and if you travel along that, video degrades pretty bad, whether you're analog or whether you're using digital. I flew my Armitan Marmot with the air unit with two antenna around this paved area. Okay, it's getting really bad. Really bad. And we are back, but you can see that was not pretty. And then I decided to fly the Beta 95X with the Vista around the same area. All right, that's where it gets chewed, right there. Nasty, but similar. And is it just me, or is this actually not so bad? Wow. Now, I've crashed my air unit a lot. I mean, maybe. I've damaged it a little bit, but I haven't noticed any degradation in quality of the air unit over the last couple months. So perhaps this little antenna right here is actually outperforming the air unit antenna? I have no idea. I'm using stock antenna on the goggles, stock everything, so kind of interesting. I'm not complaining. I just think it's interesting that a little Cadex Vista like this is outperforming the full-size air unit. The full-size air unit with antenna is about 54 grams in weight, and the Cadex Vista is about 33 grams with its antenna and its camera. So definitely a lot lighter and smaller form factor. It's a 20 by 20, so you can put this into a 20 by 20 stack. Also, you know how the air unit can only be powered by up to 4S battery voltage? The Cadex Vista can be powered straight off of 6S voltage. So it may not be the perfect solution for everybody, especially considering it doesn't have internal recording. But if you want to have a good flight experience with something really, really small, then this might be your best bet. So now the 95X, what do I like about it? Well, it's basically a Beta 85X components, but with a larger frame to accommodate the 2.5-inch props. You can buy the 95X with the Cadex Vista already inside of it for about $300 on their website. Check that out. But this is the one that I built myself, and it was pretty easy to put in there. I mean, it is a little bit tight inside of here, and I'll tell you what, this canopy that goes around the camera is a little bit tight, and it means that the camera is pushing up against the top of the Vista, which means I can't really bend this camera up or down very much. It's kind of locked in place because it's so tight in there. I wouldn't mind seeing a little bit larger canopy, maybe a little more elbow room, then we can get a little bit more of a camera tilt. Also, the camera doesn't fit into the actual camera slot, like for the screw that would normally fit the camera. It goes into one of these little gills underneath. I think that's kind of interesting, but that's how it gets mounted and that's how it works. That's the protector, the little 3D printed lens protector for this, because the lens does protrude out past the canopy. The motors here are 1106 4500 kV motors. So I was running it at 4S today, and I was actually running it 4S and Acro in the house here with a heavy throttle limit. But outside, I opened it up. It's got a lot of power. It feels good. Punch outs feel really good. However, I guess because it's so light and the ducts around the props, when it falls and you try and catch yourself, you get prop wash city. It's kind of nasty. And in fact, it caused me to crash one time because I was kind of falling down. I was going to catch myself, and then the prop wash kind of made me dip to the side a little bit. And so I lost some of my thrust and I hit the ground. By the way, I'm just running the Beta FPV 450 milliamp hour 4S batteries. And this is XT30, and they give you a little capacitor on there, which is nice. And so you can see the body here is partly carbon fiber, kind of almost like toothpick design, and then partly the plastic. The flight controller is separate from the ESC, so we have two different boards. This Rush VTX is, of course, left-hand polarized because that's how our DJI goggle antenna are. And the props that they give us are 25 40 GemFan. Now, when you think about micros, you think about a tiny little noise that they make. This actually puts out a decent amount of noise at 4S. I was flying it out at the park, and I was more than a couple hundred feet away, and I could still hear myself ripping pretty hard. So it's not the silent ripper, but it is a lot quieter than maybe some 3 and 4 inch quads that you've heard that are still under 250 grams. One thing I'm slightly concerned about is just how this canopy is gonna be held on in a big crash. I feel like it's gonna get broken off. Only 3 screws actually hold this on, and because of the Cadex Vista, the shape of it with the 2020 stack, it's actually being held by the canopy and not by the rest of the frame. So the canopy is actually supporting the Vista and the camera of the Vista and the antenna with only 3 little screws in the plastic. That might break. But I've crashed this 2 or 3 times now and it has not broken, so. I flew this in a couple areas where video transmission wasn't that great. Now, I remember that it was not great with air units either, so I can't blame it on the Vista. But there were some places where I was really close to me, and like myself, and I still got kind of mushy video. I went back and I turned on focus mode, put it on auto, and that way at least I could see directly in front of me. Not every environment is going to be great for the DJI FPV system. Also, if you have issues on like what I was trying to do was DJI Frequency 7, go to 1 or 3, see if there are better channels within the DJI band that you can go to and see if you can improve your situation. Because yeah, there were some places I was flying and I was like, wow, this is really crappy video for the DJI system. But then I went to another spot and it was fine again. Now, as a reviewer, I got this and things were not quite set up as well as I was hoping, because I got the Cadex Vista sent to me separate from the 95X like frame and components. So I had to go into Betaflight, had to select Crossfire because it was preset to SBUS, had to go to the ports tab and select MSP on the proper UART for the Cadex system. So there was a little bit of work. I don't know. I hope that when they ship this as a complete package to you, you're going to be able to get off the, you know, get up off the ground flying. One thing that I also found interesting was the Omnibus F4 flight controller only had Betaflight 3.5.7. And as we know, if we want to use the HDL protocol, you got to have a higher, more recent version of Betaflight. And if you want to use like your custom OSD on your goggles, you actually have to have like Betaflight 4.1 point something. So it's you're going to have to update it if you don't have the latest in Betaflight. But I was able to fly just fine the way I do with Crossfire and the goggles like this with Betaflight 3.5.7. And I'm just trusting that it's tuned okay. I think it could be tuned a little better. Again, it's probably because I got something that was a little more stock. There is a CLI dump on the Beta FPV website, so you can dump all that in here and you probably have some PIDs that they've adjusted or stuff like that. I don't think this is a drone that you want to be crashing frequently. I don't think it's quite as robust as maybe like a Armitson Chameleon or something. But at the same time, I think you're gonna have a great time with this indoors and outdoors. I keep talking about this time of year in the Northern Hemisphere. It's January. You know, we want to find something that we can fly indoors and outdoors. And a lot of times, flying indoors with a micro meant you're going to have to make some compromises and you're going to have to fly analog. Not anymore, guys. Maybe set yourself a throttle limit or use this with a 3S battery. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. Check out the link in the video description to the Beta 95X as well as the Cadex Vista. And if you want to order the Cadex Vista separately, let me know what you're going to use it with down in the comments below, what quad you're going to put it in. I'm interested to hear what types of things that you're going to add. I mean, you're going to put them into a wing, or you're going to put them into a little RC car. I mean, hey, the possibilities are endless. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, everybody. Until next time, happy flying.